Authority.
Executive order from the department.
Come on, guys. We're out of here.
Celebrity. Now how are we gonna live in your big shadow? Give me that.
Yeah, I'll make it. Oh. Who's that?
You're gonna kill me.
I don't know. I mean, can't you just call in sick?
Come on, Jess. This is the Air Force. So, did they tell you what it's all about?
Top secret.
So much for our vacation.
She's disappointed.
So am I. I mean, how long has she been planning this? Now it's just not gonna happen. Knock, knock.
What's the matter with Chang?
Top secret.
Devious evade state interference by the men of the 78th Infantry Battalion and the 220th Airlift Wing, both based here in Cebu. As a Cebuano, I am proud to announce the largest gold recovery in the history of the Philippines.
That finally, a large amount of wealth stolen from the Philippine people can be returned to them. The fine will be transported to Manila and turned over to the Central Bank of the Philippines to be recorded as recovered property of the people of the Philippines.
This is Maria Pineda reporting live from Mactan Air Base,
where a spectacular find of gold is now being loaded into a transport plane.
How are you doing?
Yes.
Now it's time to turn off all electronic devices. That goes for Captain, too.
Yes, sir.
Colonel Diaz, can you tell us more about this?
The AFP will work with the task force. We've selected a transport team, the 222nd Airlift Wing of Cebu, to escort the gold to Manila, where custody will be transferred to the Banco Central.
You know, one of those little gold bars will kind of come in handy now.
I know.
Flight 593 Delta Echo, proceed left for south departure. You are cleared for takeoff.
Roger that.
Hey, sir, you better take a look at this.
What's going on?
He's going off course.
Air Force 3633, please come in.
And that was a special request for my old fishing buddy. I don't know about you guys, but it sure does wake up those old memories for me.
That's a go flight.
Holy crap, are you sure?
Yeah. P633, you're completely off course. Your heading is 152 degrees. Air Force 3633.
Chang, I'm really sorry.
Look, there was a problem with the bank, all right? I'll get you a new check right away.
No check. I like simple things. Cash, simple. No cash. Double.
Wake her?
No. Let her sleep. We've been up all night. You've been really kind.
No problem. You tried to call soldier people?
They won't tell us anything.
They think Amy's boyfriend stole code? Listen, if you don't pay me cash, I take off.
What are they doing here?
Miss Amy Sanchez?
Yes.
You're Captain De La Cruz's girlfriend, right? When was the last time you saw him?
Yesterday morning. She dropped him off at the airbase.
Miss Sanchez, you haven't seen him since then? Miss Sanchez.
You haven't found him?
We don't know where he is. You sure you haven't seen him?
No, I haven't.
Has he contacted you?
No. Do you know what happened to him? Did you find the plane?
Millions in gold missing, Miss Sanchez.
What are you implying?
Where was it when it went off radar?
I can't tell you that.
Why not? I have a right to know.
Miss Sanchez, we are aware of your financial hardships.
What are you trying to say? That Tony took the gold? He'd never do that. He spent his whole life in the military.
But we're asking you not to leave town.
Do you have an arrest warrant? Because if you don't, then I suggest that you leave.
How about it, Colonel Diaz? Have you got a warrant?
At the moment, all we got from Miss Sanchez is questions.
What about her boyfriend? Is he a suspect?
We can't exclude anybody right now.
Have you found the gold yet?
No, we have not found it. We're just trying to see if the military's involved.
You ought to be out searching for him. He could be injured or even dead, and you question his loyalty?
We'll be in touch, Miss Sanchez.
He had nothing to do with this. I'll prove it. I'm gonna find out what happened to Tony, because if I don't, nobody will.
A defiant Miss Amy Sanchez, defending her missing boyfriend.
That's my girl.
I'm proud of you, honey, but how are we gonna get our boat back?
Well, maybe I can help.
Frank.
No, don't worry about it. Just do me one favor, okay? Be careful. I don't want you guys stepping on anybody's toes.
How much is there?
Not enough to square us with Chang. I need to meet with someone. I need your help, John. They won't tell me anything.
Not too surprising, considering the shot you took at them today.
You know this stuff. How do I start? Where do I go?
I can't do anything for you, and you know that.
Just point me in the right direction.
I always had the greatest respect for Tony. He was a great guy. I'm sorry. I shouldn't put it that way. Look, this is a delicate matter. The armed forces has issued a strict gag order, and I need to be cautious. But I'll see what I can do.
The scope of these operations is quite impressive. No effort, no resources have been spared. As these pictures start coming in, it looks more and more like the plane might have really gone down.
If there was a crash, sources close to the investigation say the probable location will make it difficult to recover the gold. The
plane still has not been found, but if it went down where it was last spotted, the government may be forced to give it up for lost.
Not enough!
Chang. You're a gambling man. Unchain our boat. We'll pay you double.
When?
Soon as we find Tony.
No. Before Chinese New Year, and you pay me four times as you owe me.
Three.
A friend of mine picked something up. Look, it hasn't been checked out, but someone saw a plane flying low.
Where?
I can't tell you that. Have a great trip. Oh, and by the way, I hear the lighthouse there is worth visiting.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes?
Would you know where Mr. Chang is?
No, I haven't seen him today.
I have a package for him from... I believe it's urgent.
Sure, no problem.
I have it right here. Let's go.
Trouble.
You're going after Tony, aren't you?
You didn't hit my lighthouse here.
I think it was the Gold's plane.
How do you know that?
It sure as hell wasn't Santa Claus and his reindeers.
Did you see what happened to it?
Yeah, it crashed. Sink out of sight fast, man. I saw with my own two eyes. The army don't want the word to get around, so don't say anything.
Where exactly did it go down?
Right out there. And I'm telling you, I had a front row seat. I guess those cowboys in the cockpit want to get away with the gold, and boom, splash, gone. Hey, sweetie, what's wrong?
One of those cowboys was my boyfriend. And just so you know, he would never do that.
Okay, listen. I've been saying way too much already. The military came in here. Some guy stood right there and ordered me to keep my mouth shut. They're worried about this place becoming a zoo or something with treasure hunters coming from all over the world.
But I don't understand. I mean, why hasn't there been any recovery efforts? There's nobody out there.
I don't know. I think the ocean is too deep out there or something.
Well, do you have any depth charts?
You want to see depth charts? Why don't you just go check out the library?
Not the lending kind of library.
Oh, can I make copies?
I guess I have to make an exception.
I've been looking for you.
Me?
You're Amy Sanchez, aren't you?
Yeah.
My name is Benny Simpson. I'm a freelance writer for Globetrotter magazine. And this is my wife, Claire.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Can we join you?
Yeah, sure.
We saw you on TV and went to the Cebu Marina. And a rather plum Chinese gentleman told us that you're here in San Vicente. I think your story is fantastic. I'd like to cover it for Globetrotter.
It's awful what happened to your boyfriend, but what you're doing for him now, it's great. Benny thinks the whole world should know about it.
Would you have an expense account? So, welcome
Thank
aboard.
You.
Thank you. So, what brought you guys to Cebu in the first place?
Well, we came here 4 years ago for the diving, and since then we just haven't been able to stay away.
I guess we're not designed for these European winters.
What do you write about?
Well, there was a cover story we did last March about Palawan.
Palawan, yeah. And you know what? I think this story could make it to the cover as well.
Cheers.
The firm reports the plane vanished somewhere over the northern tip of Leyte.
Leyte?
They're wrong. The plane is here. We spoke to an eyewitness.
Not the crazy lighthouse lady. She's not your only source, is she?
I believe her. Listen, you don't have to join us.
It's okay. We said we would, so you can count on us.
I'm gonna go to bed, darling.
It's late.
Good night.
Thank you.
Gracias.
Son of a gun. I knew it.
You can't be here. I suggest you go home.
What, are you threatening us?
Just a little friendly advice.
Oh, will you shove your friendly advice up your ass? Because the last time I checked, this was a free country. And we have a member of the international press with us. So we don't want to be giving them the wrong impression of our country now, do we? Let's go.
Well, they'll probably be interested to know that we found a parachute just a couple hundred yards from the lighthouse. Have a nice day.
The plane sink. It could have floated for a while.
You mean just under the water?
Yeah, where the current could pull it.
Did you ever get the tide tables?
Yes, and the current that afternoon was from the south. It probably carried the plane over this way.
But it's over 2,000 meters deep there. I mean, the Navy has like deep sea robots, but what about us?
Oh, well, we got an R2-D2 and a C-3PO downstairs. Piece of cake.
Weather update. So, what's the plan?
Girls.
Who's hungry?
So here's some baby-making music, just for you guys.
He's right. I've really got nothing for you to write about. So we can leave tomorrow so we can get you guys back to Cebu.
Nice to see you again. Now you can make copies. I've got the machine fixed just for you, in case you came back.
Well, didn't you say I would?
It doesn't matter if you never came back, because depth charts are all wrong.
Wrong? Can I call you later? Thank you.
Thanks, Jose. You're the best. Get this. During the war, in the middle of Japanese occupation, a military ship sank here.
So they altered the charts for the Japanese to make it look impossible to recover the vessel and the stuff that was on it.
Wow. That's what I call a story. Now, how do you know all this?
The library guy. His grandfather was mayor at the time.
And they never revised the charts.
Wow, this thing looks really ancient.
Yeah, our depth gauge just goes down to 100.
And we can't search the bottom without better equipment.
It's 80 over there. But right here, underneath us, it's about 40 or 50 meters. How's that for a story, Benny? So you can help us get sonar?
I got everything you need right in here. You know the locals call me MacGyver because I can fix anything. I might be able to put something together for you guys, but it ain't going to be cheap.
Don't worry. We have a sponsor now.
Who? The people on your boat?
Yeah, they're going to feature us in their Globetrotter magazine.
What?
Yeah.
Okay, you get me broadcast rights, and you're going to think the price tag on this is beautiful.
Deal.
Nice boat.
Hey, no bad mouthing. It's not as old as your boat.
True.
Besides, how long did it take you guys to get here from Cebu?
Only a couple of days.
Your parents still live there? Do you see them often?
No. Not exactly, no.
Are you guys even close?
You know, I'd rather we didn't talk about that. Let's just get the stuff loaded, okay?
We've got everything you need right here.
Anything wrong with Jess?
I asked her something about your parents, and after that, she just hasn't been the same. What's the story?
Papa died when we were little. This was his boat. We grew up on the Ariella. His big dream was to catalog all the marine life in the Philippines.
Hi, Daddy!
So the whole world could see the beauty of the oceans.
Hi, girls.
I'm gonna get him the water.
He spent most of his money on underwater photography equipment. And for almost 2 years, our home was this boat.
You spot the snake?
Aggressive, huh?
Oh, one of the biggest I've ever seen.
He said if we take things for granted, we do not learn to appreciate. He taught us if we do not preserve,
Daddy,
all that can disappear, be lost forever.
I'll get it.
Do you have enough air?
Never mind.
I thought I would know how to appreciate. And when we lost him, we knew that we learned nothing.
Daddy!
He gave me his love of the sea, but Jess went the other way. She's scared to go in it.
Check this out. I threw in a magnetometer, which means if you come across a metal object, you're gonna get a beep. And look, I set the level so it would only react to something huge, like a plane. Watch this.
Wow.
You're in business now, baby.
Thanks.
No problem. Wait. What about my money?
Can I give you a check?
You know, our clients have gone into town, and as soon as they get back, we'll be able to...
How about I just come back later?
Mm-hmm.
no idea. Let's face it, it's a needle in the haystack. At least we tried.
I think Benny's right, Amy. The task's enormous.
The plane could have broken into pieces. It'd probably never get found.
I don't want to give up now. It's gotta be down there.